Hello and welcome to my world in Minecraft, which I've named the Farlands. Because why not? First off, before we start to explore, let us play some music. That will work. Now then, nice gentle music to go with the show of this. I effectively decided to make a treehouse as I started off just around the corner. As you can see, we're kind of in the middle of a jungle. And down here, we'll start to see my settlement, which has been included into this wooden compartment. In fact, I might be able to get a little bit of a better view. It's actually been many months since I last played this, so a lot of it's still kind of fresh to me in the way that I've just plain forgotten it. Yep, basically a lot of jungle. So, I've actually got quite a bit to show, so let us begin. Pressure pads, always of course. Oh, this is why I have my bed, my painting of a creeper, and a clock, which is less important than a painting of a creeper. Now, I had to build that, that's actually the entire point of making a treehouse. I have some cats. I love cats. I have a lot of wheat here, some pumpkins, some melons, a lot of vines. I've got more cats. Basically put, I like my cats. Now that I'm down here, since it's less to show down this side anyway, we have collision. Nope, we actually have something down here. My sugar farm. You might see the term, I kind of always go around with decorated gephiro leaves at the top. It just looks nicer. There we'll see some lava, which we'll be going to in a bit. Because that will lead us on to many things. I don't have a trapdoor to seal, I don't know why I thought I did. Yes, I kind of always go overboard with a whole leaf decoration, but hey, it's nice. So we can go down there, but first off, let's actually explore this main place first. On the first level, I basically started off from the ground, I kind of went into there, decided this would be a nice place, started building to the floor, and before you knew it, I basically just made my entire settlement here. We have a handy disposal room, and also that, which is a very good handy tip, because I kind of got myself stuck in there a few times. It's good not to get yourself stuck in lava. There's some water on the outside in case you ever actually die, to make sure I can go down. And I've got another cat. And a lot of storage, which I've basically barely used. On the next level, there'll be something down there that we'll be seeing in a bit. We have another bed here. And this goes back into my treehouse, which is a bed inside. Why did I make another bed? Who knows? Now then, here is one of my favourite things, my pool room. Well, less of a pool and more just a bath. Gentle, relaxing bathing. Get to look about all my creation. Including that. That I've named the cube. Because there's a cube. We'll be seeing that in a bit, but first off, up here we have my library. Lots of nice dusty tomes to look at. That one's my favourite, it's actually a comic book series. And that one less so, but I kind of need it for class. And up here, we have books that actually have a purpose, because we can enchant stuff here. Of course, using a pumpkin for lighting. Keeps it atmospheric. So yeah, this is my favourite room in the entire game at the moment, actually. I really like it. Now then, you might have noticed over here that we have that cube. I actually haven't done much in the Nether, so we might as well show it off now. Yes, it's a floating cube of nothingness. With lava falls all around it. Now those of a keen mathematical mind who've been putting far too much effort into watching this will notice that it's in fact not a cube and it's actually more of a cuboid. Sadly it just wouldn't fit in a cube because this is two across. Oh well. Let's go to the Nether. Now then, the Nether is being ridiculously laggy. And basically what I made here is, I made my own little settlement, including the Neverwood. You will not believe how long it took me to get a single piece of nether wart. I already went to a fortress, none in it, took me ages to find a second fortress. She might actually know how long that took, but you know, you'd have to kind of read my mind for it. Got a few levels here, wasn't really anything here, but you know, just kind of provides a nice view. And then here, we've got this opening. I think that was so I can do a test. Oh yeah, that's because I was lighting up the fire there. You know what? I shall keep that there. See, it looks nice. I want my chicken down there, though. I like chicken. So yes, that's pretty much all I've done in the Nether, to be honest. I mean, we've also got down here, which is yet more Nether wart. Also some flames, because it's for Nether. Yes, I decided to just go overboard with a whole Nether wart, considering the fact it took me so long to get any. I decided, you know what, I'll just make an entire field of it. So that's effectively all I've done down here. Quick tip here. Always have a flint and steel. If this gets put off, you're in bad luck. It's happened to me once. And by me, I mean Ashens, because I was watching his video. I don't think it actually did happen to me. Ah, now then, we shall slowly fade the wall back in. Oh yeah, out of interest, my spawn point was actually there. Right next to where that tree is. I came over here and wow, it was a nice place. So now that we've effectively done everything on this side, let us return down here. This leads to my mine. Down here, the water flows down to a mine shaft, which I may as well show to you, because why not? I always go overboard with the torches. To the mines! Yes, I keep having to build those signs, otherwise I forget where I'm going, especially if I haven't actually played it for months. And I get confused as to how to actually get back, so I have to put many signs when I'm actually doing stuff. Especially the Nether, I have to have many saying, "This is the way to home, you idiot." And it works surprisingly well. You see, that way we have a mine shaft, this way we have a cavern. That's a cavern, and that's a mine shaft. To the mine and to the exit. So we have a mine down here, which is nicely laid out. We also have another way to the mine up here. I completely forgot I actually have this way still available at the moment. Yeah, that way was to an abandoned shaft I made, and you know what, I'm just gonna leave. I don't feel like fighting zombies, which I could easily take. And like you see, I would have gone the wrong way there, but actually handily have these signs up, and also remember the way that I literally just went a few seconds ago. I should explain something while I'm doing the backtracking about this world. I haven't yet actually found any carrots. I've also not found enough endermen to actually get me to the end portal. I have gotten there, and I've laid a path there, which I was in the process of making a track to get there, and then I realised that was going to take far too long and I couldn't be bothered. No, that's to the mines, let's go this way. That's the way out. You can tell by the water. So effectively, I haven't been to the end yet. And also, I haven't been able to raise pigs because I don't have the carrots. And I only just, the last time I played actually, managed to get some nether wart. You know what, that's taking too long, let's have a ladder instead. I think it's quicker. But yes, where I'm actually going to now is going to be where I decided to branch out. Also, that water is to feed the, you know, reeds and all that jazz. So we got a stupid lava here that's going to kill me one day. And here, minecarts. Which isn't lagging, I thought this bit would actually destroy the recording, because it seems to lag up usually for no real reason. Well, that's Java for you. I think it's Java, isn't it? I don't know. And now let's smash into this with high-powered rails. Thank you. Now then, first off, this is the first place I went to. Haven't actually done anything out here. Oh, it's approaching night. But effectively, I just made a beacon here, went to explore, and decided to carry on digging. And that will lead us to our next location. Well, I'm gonna have to end up sleeping because it's in the night. Also, there's something above me. Yep, a bit of a smaller journey this time. But no less important, because this is to my cattle ranch. And oh yeah, I like this place, and seriously. You know when I said that I wanted to wait until night? Yeah. Let's see if we can do that. I forgot if you can sleep when enemies nearby. Yeah, you can. That's fine. Annoying enemies breaking my recordings. Yeah, we have another bath here. So you can look out over our cattle ranch. And to my flower bed, which I think I just destroyed. Well, down here, we have storage. Which you'll notice we have a lot of eggs. Okay, that's the last eggs than I thought I had. I think I just gave up farming them after a while. I kind of went a bit overboard with my egg collecting, you could say. Oh, so that chicken got loose. Hello, spider. Get away from my flowers. Thank you. Now I'm going to have to set up these flowers again, aren't I? Down my rose, put down my flower, and that will do. So yeah, so I decided to make a fountain here, which is actually surprisingly easy. I literally just made one block on each side, a block in the middle, water on top, and it actually worked surprisingly well. It's the nicest looking fountain I've ever had. There's a chicken out of the pen. So basically, but we have chickens. We have a lot of chickens. Like I said, I went a bit overboard with it. And over here, we have our cattle, we have sheep, and we have cows, and we have a lot of them. Sadly, like I said though, we don't have any pigs. I've yet to actually find any carrots. And over here, we have, well, basically what's gonna happen is, that's supposed to be wheat, that's supposed to be carrots, and that's supposed to be potatoes. But yeah, I've only actually managed to find wheat so far because I found neither carrots nor potatoes. So, you know, kind of annoying. So instead I've just got a ridiculously large quantity of wheat. But you know, it still looks nice. So yeah, I basically got as much beef, leather. I don't think leather's really used for anything though. Wool. Eggs, chicken. What are you even doing there? Basically, we got a lot of stuff. And down here, I think it's down here anyway. Yeah, I think that's a way to a shaft, but I think there's a better way down there. I think I built a way to a nearby shaft if I end up mining. Yeah, basically down there, however the best way to get us to it is where I started mining for diamond. I finally found my first piece of diamond, which took me a long time for some reason. There's also a village over to that side, but it's a small one that doesn't really have anything of use. But anyway, that's what I wanted to show. I actually really like this place. It took me a long time to find a suitable location. I had to level it out a bit, but you know. Basically, I made my cattle ranch. It's only really disappointing I don't have any... Ow. I don't have any pigs, carrots, or potatoes. But you know. What matters is I have a bone in my hand, but now I have chicken in my hand. So what we're going to do here is, well, we're just basically just going to go home at this point. I'm not going to show you to where the end portal is because that's ridiculously far and I literally haven't done anything to it yet. All I really did was take away books so I could use them back home and that was about it. It did have quite a sizable library in it. So yeah, that's basically my Minecraft world. So, that's basically the video that I've been meaning to do for a long time. Hopefully one day I'll get those stay open replacements, but for the time being, we're just going to go home and go and relax in my bath. I love my cats. I miss my cat. So, that's been my Minecraft world. And I doubt I'll really show another video of it at any point. But you know, the one video that I did do, it's kind of a staple Let's Player thing, but you all have to make one eventually, so you know what? That's done. So let's just take a moment and just relax. Sit back. And that's about it. So farewell, lovely pony, and have a nice bath tonight. Because Steve certainly shall. They're all called Steve, aren't they? I don't know, he's called Steve in Meat Boy, so I'm going to stay with Steve. Farewell, Steve.